Hello everyone, I'm Mazhar Ali and I welcome you to Python for Beginners. This tutorial is designed for beginners or new ones who are interested in learning the Python. I will use Jupyter Notebook IDE or Interactive Development Environment for learning. So Jupyter Notebook is a document or it's a type of the document that's produced by the Jupyter Notebook app. The Jupyter Notebook app is a server client application that allows you in editing and running notebook documents via a web browser. And you can execute the documents in Jupyter Notebook even on the local desktop environment requiring no internet access, or installed on a remote server and accessed through the internet. So it depends on you, either you are using in the server client environment or in the local environment. However, it's a popular environment for the Python, though there are different environments like the PyCharm, like the integrated development learning environment that generates the scripts for Python. Even you may work on the Python prompt. So it depends on you. Where you feel easy, you may start your work on the Python. I feel myself easy in the Jupyter Notebook because this provides a very good environment in generating the data structures and generating the models and other things in the Python. So this is a beginner course, but after this, we will go for the professional level and we will learn how to use the machine learning algorithms, how to analyze the images, and how to run the text for different purposes. And then we will go for the deep learning. So therefore, I choose the Jupyter Notebook. Now question arises, why Python? Now, Python is a very popular programming language of the computer, which is used to solve the various real-world problems. We face several real world problems in our life from morning to night. Therefore, we need programming languages. So there are different and various computing languages which provide us facility to solve the real world programming. But Python is a very easy to use than the other computing languages. We don't need to generate extra code in the Python like in other languages. For example, if I want to print hello world, I have to write several lines for this little string hello world. But in Python, just we will write print hello world. So this is the difference between the Python and other words. So you may even program after learning the Python, you may program for the artificial intelligence. You may develop several artificial intelligent agents, expert systems, and other artificial intelligence programs. You may develop the program for automation, even for the automation for driving, automation of different instruments, tools, the robots, and so on. And you may develop programming for automation. Even you may develop different types of computer application using the Python environment. So it is not limited to the simple machine learning, but Python is an open source, open programming language where you may write a program and develop various types of the application. You may develop the websites on basis of your programming and so on. So Python is a platform which is provided to you that work on Python and solve the real world problems which we are facing day to day. Python is a high level language, therefore it is very easy to use. Though there are other high level languages, but those are not as easy as the Python. As I told you, we don't need to write extra programming lines to print the hello world as in other high level languages we used to write. And formal language means Python is a formal language with its own specific rules and formats, which will you learn in the coming lectures. Even in this part of the tutorial, you will learn some rules and formats of the Python. So gradually you will learn that what are the rules and formats of the Python. And If you work 2 hours daily for 3 months, means if you work on the Python 2 hours daily for 3 months, you will be good at Python. However, you will not be an expert, but you will be a good programmer of the Python. And you may get a job of junior programmer in a very good organization and earn a good salary package. And you may live a very good life. So Python is a very good source of earning. It's a source of earning and it's a source of solution. So this tutorial is only designed for the beginners or new ones. Therefore, learning basic skills will help the beginners in breaking down problems into manageable parts. What are the problems available in this world? You may break down them in manageable parts. You may solve them. Building up creative solution for different real world problems. Making sure the solutions are clear for humans means those solutions will be usable. Those solutions will really solution for the real world problems. And making sure the solution also work correctly on the computer. Means what solutions you are giving to the world, that those solutions will run properly on the computer and solve the real world problems. So you will be able to do these 4 things. And what you will learn in this training, means this part of training which I am going to deliver today. You will learn strings, how to write strings, and the basic string operations. You will learn to generate lists. You will learn basic operators of the mathematics, and you may learn to create a basic calculator for the solution of mathematical problems. You will learn to use the data types, loops, and selection conditions in the Python. And you may be able to create the dictionaries after joining this session of training. So let's get to learn. Subscribe this channel and mark the bell icon that you may receive the notifications automatically, because this is our part one. So you need to learn part two and again part three and so on, that you may develop from junior to or from new to professional programmer. So subscribe first and then continue. This will help you in learning the Python. So you may work on the Jupyter notebook when you have installed the Jupyter notebook on your system. So I did give this training before, so that tutorial of installing the Jupyter is available in my channel. I will put the link of training in the description box, so you may open the training if you have not installed the Jupyter notebook on your system. So to work on the Jupyter notebook, you have to create a new file. So to new file, you have to come to the new file. But before going to work on the new file, you have to think that where you have to store the your programming editor or the your coding, where you will store. So you have to store this coding on a safe place in the computer system. So if you will store it in the C drive or on the desktop or on the My Document, so that may be crash if your computer is going to be faulty. So think before keeping your important coding. So I suggest you to keep it in the secondary drive, means the D drive or E drive and so on. So I have created a file on the desktop here. I go to that, so I just press the desktop button and I will open the file, tutorials for beginner. So I will just open this file. Okay, so here though there is a file, but I'm not opening this. I generate new file. I press here new, And you look here, there are different options. Either you are going to create a new Python 3 file or text file or your folder or anything. So we will going to we are going to create the Python file. So I will just paste the Python 3. So this file is opened. So now we have to give the file name because it is untitled here. So there may be different untitled files. So we will go. We will give the name to the this file. So I will just give them learning. So I rename it. You may give a name of your choice to the file. So rename it. Now you look here. This is a file learning where we will work. So we will work in the learning file. And this is the Python Jupyter Notebook environment. It is called the Jupyter Interactive Development Environment. So you see all programmers or all the learners start with the learning how to print the hello world. So to print the hello world in the Python environment is a very easy in the other words, because if you will print the hello world in other programming languages, you have to write several lines, but in the Python just you have to write the print and brackets and then the quotation marks, and we will write the hello world and we will execute this. So it's a very simple in the Python. So we will execute through the execute button here. This is the execute button, though there is another way to execute this, that is the shortcut key. So I will tell you in the next query that how we may run the file with the shortcut key. So is this is the first, we will go through the execution button. This is the execution button. When look here, run cell. So I will just press this button and you will see. So it tells that print is not defined. So I write here capital P. So it's a case sensitive language. So I have provided the simple P, and you see here the color of this print is a changed now. So I will just press this button again and you will see the result, hello world. So keep in your mind, if you are not taking care of the case sensitive words, then you may face the errors. Though it was very simple error, but I identify that it is the case sensitive error. I mistakenly wrote the P in a capital format. So you have to write print in a small, not in the capital. Okay, so again, for example, I'm going to write here print and quotation marks hello world, and I give the symbol and I enter. And I want to write again print another line. Print quotation marks. This is my first program in the Python. Okay, here you may write capital or small. I'm going to write the Python P capital. So Python Jupyter IDE. And I will use the shortcut, as I told you in next transition. I will tell you. So shortcut is very easy. You have to just press the shift and enter. So I press the shift and enter, and you will see the result. Hello world. This is my first program in the Python Jupyter IDE. So you may print the numbers and strings in the Python without writing the extra code. So for example, if I will print the number, what will I do? You know the different. When we are going to print the string, we have to give the quotation marks to the string or text. But when we are going to print the numbers, we don't need a quotation mark in the computer programming languages. So I just write here the 1, 2, 3, 4. I tell you why I given the commas here. So I again press the shift enter. So here the print is not defined. Again, I made mistake in the print. You see, so These are very helpful for you because you don't do such mistakes. So I made a wrong mistake, wrong experience. So now printing is okay and okay. And I press shift enter and you see 1, 2, 3, 4 with the proper spacing. But again, I show you why I given commas here. So if I write here print 1, 2, 3, this will show the error. Why error? I tell you. Let's wait. So I shift press. Okay, this is an error. I told you already, and it shows invalid syntax, and definitely it is an invalid syntax. So what do you think? Why this error comes? Okay, I tell you. I told you already that when we write a string, we have to we need to give the quotation marks. And when if we are not writing the string and only numbers, then we have to write the numbers without quotation marks. So here this space is basically a string. You know, this space is a string. That's why I give the commas. So if I will give quotation marks to these numbers, then definitely this will run properly. So I give the quotation marks here and here, and I press shift and enter, and you will see the result. Okay, so result is a 1, 2, 3 because there was a string in form of gap. And if you don't want to make it the string, then what will you do? So you will just remove the quotation and give the commas. So this is the difference between the string and number printing. So keep in mind, when you are going to print the number, give the commas. And if you want to, if you don't want to give the commas, then make it the string. So, for example, now I'm going to work on again on the basic operators. So, how many operators are here? If I show you, plus means addition, minus multiplication, and the division. So these are the quotation marks. Basic operators are mathematical. And you see, I give him the here the hashtag. Now hashtag make them the comment. So if you want to give the comment on any of this command query, you may command, you may give the comment here like hash, and you may write anything here for the ABC. Anything you may write here. So for example, if I'm going to write here comment. 2 plus 3 and shift enter, so it will give the 5. And if I give the print 5 minus 3, so it will give you result 2. And if you give if you write print 3 into 3, so it will be 9. And if I write here print 10 division 3, so you will see the result. So now you may even make your own small calculator and get the result. So even you may write this command in one query as well. 10 plus 5 into 2 divided by 5, and you may get the result. So you may make the basic calculator. So go for basic calculator. You may write. This is assignment for you. After completion of your assignment, get pause and try to write this code. Then I will show you how to write the or get the emojis with the text. Let's get pause. Okay, hope you did or developed the basic calculation program or basic calculator. So I told you that I will train you in generating the emojis. So to generate the emojis, you know it's a problem if you will do in the other languages of computer, you will have to write several lines. Even in the, for example, you are using any deep learning, machine learning, you may have to write several code. But I show you the secret that how in a one line you may generate the emoji. So to generate an emoji of your interest, you will have to go to the unicode.org website and then open the emoji and the charts and the emoji list. You have to open the emoji list and you see there are unicode for each emoji. If you look here, this is a grinning face, and this is for other, this is several emojis are here. You may take just only this code and then you have to come to the your environment and write here, for example, and this is the emoji. What I did, if you see what I did, I converted this pillars. I converted this pillars into 30. Look here, I converted that pillars in 30 and did the forward slash. I did only this. So this is the tip for you. And if you want to press shift enter, you will see the image. And if you want to write hello, for example, hello, I'm happy. And you may get this emoji. Hello, I'm happy. So you may write several emojis like that. Just you have to take the emojis from this, convert the plus into zero, add forward slash before this, and write the message of your interest and get the emoji. So this is a very easy way. You don't need to write several lines to show the emojis like in other languages. That's why I told you that Python is a very good language. And the Jupyter Notebook is a very good interactive environment. So make more emojis for you. This is your assignment. And after this, we will go for data types that we may run several other strings and other operations. So welcome you back. Hope you developed the different emojis according to your interest and concatenated with your different messages. And now we are going to discuss the data types. Data types, the data type is an attribute of data which tells the compiler or interpreter how the programmer intends to use the data. Means either the data is an integer, either the data is a float, either the data is a character, or either the data is a string. So the data type tells the compiler or interpreter. So most programming languages of the computer support basic data types of the integer numbers, floating point numbers, characters, and even the booleans, yes, no, and so on. So the data stored in the memory can be of many types that may be in the numbers and the text, in the characters or the strings, or in a different form may be stored in the memory. For example, a person's age is stored as a numerical value and his or her address is stored as a numerical character. So it depends on the value or on the data, that what type of the data are you going to store in the memory. So when you are going to store any type of the data into memory, you need a data type. Data type may be variable, may be constant, but you need. So Python has a various standards data types that are used to define the operations possible on them and the storage methods, each of them. We will discuss string and numbers in today's training, means string and numbers. So we start with the strings. So I define the data type str. Str is a basic data type and assign a value hello world to str. So we just write the str, this is the data type, and assign any value. For example, I assign it the value hello world, and I execute it by pressing the shift enter, or even you may press the this execution button as well. So I feel easy to press the shift and enter. So I just press it, and now you see value is stored in the string variable. So the value is stored in this data type, means this value will be stored in the memory with this data type. This data type identify this value, and I give command print to system to print the value. What is the value that is assigned to data type string str that showed to us? So I just press the shift enter, and you see hello world, because hello world is assigned to this data type. So data type store the data into memory with the proper identification. Now there are different strings and there are different operations of the string. So for example, if we want to know that what is the first character in this string, obviously, we human can identify that H is the first character in this string, but how computer know? So we will write a command, just print string. What we want, you, one thing keep in mind, computer starts counting from zero, not from one. So definitely we will, when we want to know the first character of this string, then definitely there should be, that should be in our mind that it should be the zero. So we just press the, we write print string, and in the here the zero, we will write in bracket into zero. So we will just shift enter, and you see it shows us to H. I wrote this command to save the time. I don't want to take your more time. I know that several people getting bored when they are watching the long tutorials. So I make this tutorial very short. That's why I wrote this command to save the time, because I show you how to write the command, how to write the print command, how to write other commands. So now you know, and you are expert, and you did practice on your system as well. So just print the string I show here. This is a data type. So I show him, when we write any data type, we don't need to give any quotation mark. So you give even the double quotation mark or in the single quotation mark, it depend on you. So I asked him to show the first value, but if you want to show show the third value, so third value will be 0, 1, 2, 3, L, again L, so you may see. It's a L because it's a third value, and O is a fourth value. So if you want to see the fourth value, you may see the fourth value is a O, and this is a fifth value, and so on. So make practice. You may write this string with the data type and print the different values. You may see. For example, again, I want to see that a character from value 2 to 5. So we may definitely, so just I print shift enter, we have to write print string 2 to 5. So execute it, and you will see 2 to 5. So look here, 0 1 2 2 is a L, 2 3 4, and this is a 5. And if you see, this is a 5 here. 5 is a basically gap, so it is a 5. But I go to again, and I'm going to here 6, because there's a gap, it could not show. Okay, so there was 2 space, that's why it show a space. There are 2 space. So if I when I wrote here 2 to 7, it shows double L O space W. So you may see the different announcement means print first character of the string, print the middle characters of a string, print a length of a string from 1 to 5, and you may write and get the result as well. For example, I'm going to double this string. What is our string? Hello world. And I want to print double. So I just write print str, that is our data type, and str is a consisted of value hello world and multiplied by 2. So you may even announce and execute it by shift enter. You see hello world, and if you Right, three, then you will see it will be hello world, hello world, hello world. So you may even multiply the string. If you again write several times a string, you may multiply that string by writing simple print string multiplied by 3, 4, 5, so on. So it depend on you. Or if you want to add something to your string, even you may string by performing a basic operations. So just print string str. Keep in mind, str is a consisted of hello word plus means add something. What? Another word, taste, means taste to str. And what is str? Hello word. So just execute it by this button of press enter, shift enter. So you see here hello word and the taste is added to this. So you may write anything. Hello word, it's me. So these words will be added to this. Hello world, it's me. Even you may give gap here. Hello world, so I give the gap here. Hello world, it's me. So even you may write here your name. What is your name? You may write here, writing your friend's name. It's my friend John. It's my friend John. It's my friend Sandy, and so on. You may write, it's my friend Mohan. It's my friend Aslam, and so on. You may write several names. You may write, it's me, Muhammad Ali. So you may write several names here. Now come, I give you this assignment. There once was a man named Aslam. He was 70 years old. He really liked the name Aslam, but didn't like age 70. So write a data type of the name and age and adjust that in the text and get the result. Git pause and do the practice. Me waiting. Okay, come to the solution. Hope you did it. I give you the solution. This is the solution. So you may define any character name. For example, I wrote here character underscore name. You may write only name. It depend on you. Not necessary that you may write like here. You may just write name, only name. You may just write CN. You may write. So it depends on you. However, in Python, names may be separated by inserting this underscore. So for example, here, there once was a man named Aslam. So I write here the data type, character name, and assign the value Aslam. Another value is he was 70 years old. So I correct, write another data type, character underscore age. Even you may write name and age as well, and assign the value 70 because he is a 70. And I again print, give the print command, print he was. Now he was here, he was, sorry, there once was a man named, a man named, I did not write Aslam here because I assigned Aslam to the data type character underscore name. So I write here character underscore name. Then why I give here plus? I attach this name to this text. And why this plus? Because I have to attach this comma to this text. Then in next line, print he was. He was, you write here. Now, I shall not write here his age, but I shall write here the data type. This is the data type. What is his age? I have assigned to the character age. So character underscore age plus years old, full stop, quotation over, bracket over, and again, he really write the name Aslam, print, he really write the name Aslam, but didn't like age 70. So I again give the print command, but didn't like age. I didn't write here the age, but just write here the character name, character underscore age here. And again give here the plus addition. Why? Because there is a full stop of after the age. So I give him the, and now we will execute it. So it's just if you go through the button. I will, for example, now I'm going to the button. I press it. Otherwise, you may press the shift enter as well. So look here. There once was a man named Asran. He was 70 years old. He really liked the name Asran, but didn't like age 70. So you may write little stories in the Python and through the data type. We will learn how to input the data in the coming. Today when we will learn how to input the data. So that's very, very easy. Just wait, calm. Just now focus on the this. So you may make a little story of your family that our family is this. We are this brothers, we are this sisters. My father is doing this, my mother is doing this, my father's name is this, my mother's name is this, and keep their names and their job, age, and activities in data types. You may define several data types and assign those data types in the test. So this will be your practice and create some new ideas. Hope you will do it. Okay, good. Now we are going to learn the strings operations, because there are several string operations and I will teach you some of them. You may learn these by Google, those operations, but I give you idea how to use the string operations in the Python. So for example, again, I have taken the data type phrase. Why phrase? Because there are two words. So phrase is equal to basically Python tutorial. So this is a Python tutorial is a string that is assigned to the data type phrase. So I just printed first. I want to confirm, is this working fine or not? So I just shift enter to see the result. So it's working fine. Means phrase is showing its real value, the Python tutorial, and look here, this is the Python tutorial that is assigned to the data type phrase. So now I will add some taste to the, this phrase as I added above, like this one where it's me. So I add here the Python tutorial is a cool tutorial. So right here, just a print phrase. This means it. What it? Now the text what is we are going to eat should be in the quotation marks like this one. And here I give the space because it should show away from the phrase. So I just press the shift enter to execute this code, and you see Python tutorial is a cool tutorial. If I will remove this space, then is will be connected with the air. So it will not show the proper sense of understanding. That's why I keep it away from the air by giving the space. So just print phrase means the data type plus aid what you want. For example, I have a wrote here is a cool tutorial. You may add some other text. So it depends on you. And basically this business is a concatenation. It shows the concatenation means you are merging some other text with your data type. That's why I use the plus sign. Again, another operation of the string, we want to, sometimes we want to show the letters into lower case and sometimes in upper case. So it depends on us that what type of the case we want. So for example, if we want to show the Python tutorial into lower case, what we will do, we will just write the print phrase dot lower. So this is the lower function of the string operation. So I will just execute it by pressing the shift enter, and you will see Python tutorial is shown to you in lower case. But here if you see Python is in a capital, T is in a capital. But here if you see Python T and whole text string is shown to you in a lower. But if you we want to make it the upper, we just write here upper and press shift enter, and you will see now it is in a upper case. So it depends on you. And definitely as a programmer, we need such type of the operators when we make a program or when we design and develop some applications for our clients or for our organization or for our own purposes to solve the real world problem. So we need such type of the operations and functions. So again, here even you may use the boolean for this, that either this is upper or lower. So you may show, for example, if you want to, for the boolean, we use the command is. For boolean operation, we use the is command in the Python. So you will use the is when you will use the boolean. So for example, either the phrase means the Python tutorial is in uppercase. For example, I ask you question, is the phrase, this is the phrase, and Python tutorial is assigned to the phrase, is this Python tutorial is in uppercase. So this is asked in this query. Either this phrase is in uppercase, or either this phrase is in a lowercase, or either or this phrase is in a lower, means this phrase is a lower and lowercase. So this will show us by showing the result false and true. So for example, we are going to execute this, shift enter, and you will see this is not uppercase, because this is not uppercase and this is not lowercase, but it is a lower upper, because here is a lower and lower, it's a lower and lower with the capital P and T. So that's why this query is true. So you may get the result in the boolean by using this command. So this may be used with other commands as well. And another string operation is a length. We want to measure the length, that how many letters, characters in the Python tutorial. In the Python tutorial, with the phrase, through the phrase data type. So we will use the len. Definitely we use the len operator for this one. So we will just print the len, L-E-N. Now, what data type we want to see the length? So definitely we have assigned this Python tutorial to the data type phrase. So we want to see the length of phrase. So this function count the number of characters available in the data type phrase. So we just execute this by pressing the shift enter, and you will see there are 16 characters. Are there 16? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Wow. So this function has counted right. Means phrase is consisted of 16 characters. It count the space as well. So phrase is a count. You may use this function. You may create the other data type and use this function. And make the practice. As I told you, if you will practice for 2 hours daily for 3 months, you may be good at the Python. But if you will just watch this and leave it, then you will not. So if you want to get a good job in a good organization and earn money and to live a very good life, and you are interested in programming, focus and practice, practice, practice. Another operation, operations of the strings are, as I told you, you may see the characters, either this is a zero or first, as I show already. So you may even use the combine as well. For example, here if you see the in the Python tutorial, the first letter is a P, but at the fifth level it is a N. So P 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so N is on fifth. So you may see that on what level character is available. So you may even see, and we did this command already as well. So I repeat here for this string that you recall your memory. So again, we may once here we see the character names, that which character is available on which number, but we may see the index of these characters as well. For example, we want to see where P is available, either on 1 or 0 or 5 or on which number. So we may see. So this is called the index function. So we just simply, we write the print phrase dot index. The index will show the number of P here. Even you may write any character here, but first we see the P. So just shift P. Show the Python P of Python is at a zero level. As I told you, computer starts counting from the zero. So P is at a zero level. But if we see where is the N? What is the index of N? So we will just write here N and shift here. So N is at a fifth number. N is at a fifth number is this. So this index verify this query. This is the right. So you may know the N number. Even if you want to see the value of T, so you may see. C is on seven number because after fifth, there is a space that is number six. And the T of tutorial is available at seven. So you may use the index for several other counting. You may find the location of text into any message or sentence and so on. Another function of the string is a replace operator. Means you may replace the words with other words. For example, we want, this is the Python tutorial. If we want to replace Python with the Java, Visual Basic or C Sharp, you may. So it's the same, a replace function is a very easy in a Python. You just write print phrase. Phrase is our data type where the Python tutorial is assigned to this data type and dot and replace and the brackets. Now you may replace anything. For example, here I want to replace the Python with Java and I can just execute this line. So you see, this is now Java tutorial, though there is a, it is a Python tutorial, but I replace it Python with the Java. So you may change it with other as well. For example, I want Visual Basic and you may change it. For example, Visual C, you may change it. You may Sharp. So you may replace any word with anything. It depends on you that what are you doing. So replace function is a very easy also. Another function, though there are, I told you already, several operators of the string, but we do here a very little number. So another is a another title operator is a title. So title, just we want to see that what is the title of our text. So we write here print phrase dot title and we'll press shift enter and we will see the title is a Python tutorial. This is the title which we assign to the phrase. So we may you need to practice on these Python operators to make practice and learn the Python properly. So now we learn the difference between the single and double quotes. So single quote, as I told you earlier, that we may write with a single quote and double quote. So, but the proper usage of single quote is that when we use the word with the quotation marks, like here, the beginners is written here with the quotation marks. So how we will use the double quote? Therefore, we will use the single quote with this word. So for example, I have wrote here two data types. One is a course that is equal to Python is of our beginners, and beginners is a quoted means, and this shows that computer or Python has showed the beginners in output with the quotation marks. And the other, another data type is a quote, means the quotation marks and the double the sentence is with a double quote. However, here the Python, so means the apostrophe is used and apostrophe is shown with the single quote. Therefore, I used here the double quote. And I want to show you the different of usage of the single and double quote. And then I got the print. So let's execute this program and to get the result. So you see here, this is the Python is of a beginner with quotations is I shown here, about here. So it is with the quotation marks. And again, this is a Python, so course is of a beginners. So here the apostrophe is used with the single quote. So this is a different between the double quote and the single quote and how this will be managed in a Python. I will show you. You may use the Python for the even single quote and a double quote. Sometimes we have text in a different form. So like this, if you see here, hi mother, and here is our first email to you. Thank you. For example, this is the official drafting. And when you get from company or you get to your client, you may write here. So how this will be managed in the Python? Let's see. I have taken the data type text here because this is a text. Even you may name it another. You may even give it other name. So text is equal to, I have given here the three single quote. So then I wrote here, hi mother. And here is our first email to you. Thank you, support team. And these quotes are over here. And then I print this data type because this whole data is assigned to this data type. And this is stored in the memory with this name. So I just print it. And you see, this is the result. Hi mother, there's our first email to you. Thank you, support team. You may write different text and make practice by defining different variables. So there are different way you may do in the Python like in the other languages with the little trouble. There is no trouble of coding, just write a simple code. So now we are going to how to input the data. As I told you earlier, that I told you how we will input the data and process it and get the output and print those commands. So let's start. So when we input the data, means we input the data from the user. We just, for example, we are going to write a telephone directory or the basic information form. We may definitely, we will input the data. There may be different names. So we will just define the input function. So I define here the name data type. This is the data type because all data will be stored in this data type in the memory with this name in the data memory. So whole input data will be assigned to name. So name is equal to input. Input the function of the Python that inputs the data from user. And you may give any message here. I give here message, interviewer name. You may write any message. And as you will write name here, the message will be printed here. Hello and the name. What are you going, what are you going to write name? So you will be welcomed. Hello, what your name give here. For example, we are going to execute this here. John, and enter, simple enter. Because this is not execution. So simple enter and hello, John. So you may write any name here and you may just code is a very simple. You may just write here. So I enhance it with the two data types, name and age. It means what is your name and what is your age? And then the message will be appeared. Hello, name and your age is this one. So I just write here the name data type. You may change it. And assign the value to input. Input is a function of Python. Interviewer name, age, input, interviewer age, and then the message will be appeared like this. So let's see. Hello. I write here. Aslam. Enter age. For example, the age of Aslam is a 35. And enter. Hello, Aslam, you are 35. So you may change even age and name as well. But you may write such type of the programs in a Python and make a big application that will be help you in making the websites and so on. As I told you, you may write program for the artificial intelligence, for the automation, for website development, for other data input applications or information systems you may develop in the Python. Now, another thing which I'm going to tell you that is definitely different and interesting, that is called the formal strings. How we can make the strings formal with the command. So see the different and learn. This is very much interesting. So same, I take the data type with the first name. You may give any name and input interviewer first name, last name, input interviewer last name. And then the message first name plus means the concatenation and a bracket. This one, I show you the different one thing is that this means we may show the this data in this format as well is, and other is this one. This is the farmer listing, and you will see that there's a means you will found no any different, but one different you may see in the coding. This is a lengthy and this is a little. So here first name and bracket last name plus is programmer, and print this message will be print. For example, I remove it for a temporary time. I remove it and shift enter to execute. You see, hello, move on. Your last name, Jogi, enter. You see, if the last name is in to bracket, Mohan Jogi is a programmer. Now I change it, but I write here message and shift enter. Hello. Same, you see, the code is different, but you see the result. If again I write this in this area, then you may understand clearly. So I just shift enter. Hello, John. Enter last name. Any name, father John. Enter. You see, two messages appeared. First one is with this code. Though output are same, but you see, this is a farmer with I just if for the farmer string, if with the single quote, and again, right? I didn't go for these things here. These things are taken automatically. So if you see, the John is in farmer string is the same with the John is in this message. So farmer language is a very useful in the Python for the string writing and for the different styles of the data. So let's see. Now we will work on the numbers using different data types. So before working on the numbers, you have to practice. So you have to assignment, write a program that take the name, age, your last name, your job, your address and phone number. So take pause and write that application. We meet again with the new task, that is to work on the numbers. So welcome you back. Hope you did the assignment completed. Now we are working on the numbers using the Python Jupyter interactive development environment. Numbers are definitely different than the strings. So these are the constant as well. So for example, I want to print two with the means simple decimal or with the floating number or other numbers. I just write the print two or 2.0987 or minus two and so on. So we simply get print of these. It's a very simple we learned before in the starting of this tutorial. However, even we learned this and I gave you assignment and you did this, the 2 into 5, 3 plus into 4 into 5 and so on. And you may perform any algebraic or mathematical operation here by pressing this. So we did this, I just, show you and recall you that we did this. Now again we are going for with the data types. So I take the data type here, numb, and another is a number. So numb is equal to 5 means this is the variable number and is a value is a 5, and another is a number, the value of number is a 10. So I just print the numb and number and numb plus number. You got it? What will be the result? Here in number only the result will be 5, and in second line it will be the 5 and 10, and here there will be the addition of these both numbers. Let's see. Same here the numb, this is the number and the number, and this is the addition. So you may calculate and make the calculator and perform basic calculation as well as some complex calculations as well. Again, we perform, we work on some operators. So sometimes we need want to see the remainder in a float time or in the integers. So these are three lines here. The first one will show the remainder, and this is with some floating point, and this is with the integer. You see, the first print 10% is used to show the remainder, that what is the remainder. And definitely 10 by 2, the remainder will be 0. But in the 10 divided by 3, there will be remainder 3.333 in the floating. So if you want to see the remainder into floating point, you have to use the backslash, single backslash. And if you want to see the remainder into integer, means whole numbers, then you will use the double slash. So it's easy. Just use the print function, write any number and any sign for remainder what you want. So percentage, single backslash, and double slash backslash. Another function is, for example, we have taken the number data type here, and we have assigned the value minus 10 to this data type. Means this is a negative value. There is a negative negation sign with this value. So there are different functions in the mathematics like the ABS. So we will see the ABS and the power and it, how we get the power. We may get the power into two fields by number and comma and two. And even we may see the power through the double asterisk and maximum value, minimum value, and so on. So first we see the numbers, ABS and numbers. So here, enter, you see, this is the minus 10 and the ABS make it the whole number 10. And the power of 4.2 will be 4.16. Now it depends on you, either you are showing through this comma or by giving the double asterisk. So it depends on you. Okay, one thing more, for example, I want to add the editor line here and I'm in the mid of the Jupyter. What will I do? It's easy, don't worry. Just press this plus button and you may add several what you want. I just press the plus. You see this editor is opened and right here, the print maximum, what is the maximum in this query, what is minimum in this query, and what is the round of 4.2. So I just print these three functions of the mathematic and we'll get result. So focus on the screen. Okay, good, fine. The maximum in this bracket is a 4, because 4 is a larger than the 2. And the minimum is a 2, because 2 is smaller than the 4. And the round of 4.2 will be 4. So these are some mathematical functions which I did. And I don't want to go into the detail of these things because all we know that how these functions work, and if you are more interested, you may Google the function. But definitely, when you are interested in the Python, you are a programmer and you want to learn another language, that is Python, and we know how this round function works. So you may make practice and learn how we can. Even we may, okay, we did this. We may work on different files. Number here, I write the 30, and you will see the ABS 30. So the minus marks is automatically removed. And even the power, I show you, you may see the power again. You may change the value as well. For example, I write here the 5, and I write here the 5, and you will see the same result. No, sorry, result is a change, because here the power of 5 is a 2, but here the power of 4 is a 5. So the value definitely changed. So you may work on this. Okay, one thing more that is very much important, that is the type. For example, how we know what is this 20? How we know? Either this is a string, either this is a float, either this is a integer. How we will know? So it's a easy, just write a type. Type is a function command of the Python that show you the type of the number or text, that what type of the number is there or what type of the text is there. Just you write the type and into bracket the data, what home you want to see the home, you want to see the status. So just write, for example, I wrote here type 20. So I will execute it by pressing the shift enter. You will see it shows it's an integer because it's not float. How it will be float? When I add some decimal point to this. So for example, you are defining the data type. For example, x is a 20 and you want to see the status or value of the 20 or that what is in x. So it will show you either it's an integer or float. So just execute it by pressing the shift enter. You will see it's a same value, but here this value is assigned to the data type x. So it is an integer, but here I change it. I added the decimal point with the 4. So now the definitely the status of this number is a change than the this number, because this is an integer and this is a float. Here is a floating point. So you see this is a float because here the floating point is added to this number. And for example, in text, if we want to write the status of text, so you may write any type of the text. For example, I write here a very ancient language name, the oldest language of the world, that is the Sindhi. This language from the Indus Valley and Mohenjo-Daro is the identification of Sindhi. Sindhi is taken from the Mohenjo-Daro. So that's why I wrote here the oldest language of the world. And I want to see the type, that what is the status of this text, either this is a string or integer or number. So we will see shift enter for the execution and it will see this is a string. Even you may write here, for example, English, Urdu, Hindi, Bengali, and any language you may write here and you may see the status. And this status may be seen through the data type as well. For example, CH is a data type and this value Sindhi is assigned to the this data type, and we will execute and we want to see. Now we will see the status of data type. Not this word. Here may be any word, any text. There may be sentence, there may be single character, there may be a string and so on. So the system will, when you type the data type here and see the status of data type, the system will see the status of data type, that is what is available in this. If you assign number to this data type, the value definitely the type will be changed. So first we see this. So it is a string, but if I assign it, so assume what will be the status? The integer. And if I add floating point, then it will be float. So it depends what type of data are you going to assign to the data type. Another functions are here like the seal, floor, square root and so on. So for example, sometimes these functions are not working, then you have to import the math library from the Python that is easily be installed in the Python. If you are using the pip, just pip install math. And if you are using the Conda, you just means the Jupyter notebook with the Conda, you may write the Conda install math, so on. So I install this one with the pip. So from the math, import all the functions of mathematics, and I write here the data type number and assigned it the value 5.75. And you may see even the value, for example, print number. So here only number will be assigned what is wrote here. But if I write here print seal number, you see the seal, because it is a upper level. If it is a 5.4, then it will be definitely the floor. Otherwise, if it's a more than the 5.5, then it will be the seal. So you may use the data type, or even you may take the seal direct as well. So even you may take the Fedora as well. For example, print Fedora 3.6, you may see set 3, because we are we want to see a lower level. And even the square root, what will be the square root of 36? You may see the square root. So you may even use here the input function and perform, make the calculator of your basic calculator, means input number, and perform plus, minus, and multiplication, division, and so on. So perform, make practice on this and pause it. We will come back. So we have finished the strings. We worked on the string and learned how to use strings in the Python, then numbers, and performed basic operations on the numbers and strings. Now we are going for the selections, means if-else conditions or if-else statements. So the if-else statement executes a block of code that is given to that specific block. If a specific condition is a true, or if the condition is a false, another block of code can be executed. So use else to specify a block of code to be executed if the same and condition is a false. So use else if to specify a new condition to test if the first condition is a false. So let's work on the if and else statements. So before going to the if-else statements, and I will check your assignment. Did you complete your assignment? If not, look, I have made a little calculator using the aid only. You may aid other operations as well. So I input the data, and the data type number 1, enter a number, and put enter a first number, and then the data type 2, that's with the num2, input enter another number, and then the result will be num1 plus num2. And if you are doing, then here you may write condition if else, we will understand later. So I just here, you may make it with the addition or multiplication, division, and so on, and you will get the result. So let's execute it. So for example, first number is a 7, second number is a 8, so it would be 15. Okay, so it shows 78. Why 78? Because this is a string, and here we show here the separate numbers. So we have to make it in a, as it is a string. That's why it is a shown here. The separate, that's why it is shows as a 78. So we have to enter the string. For example, num1 is an integer and num2 is also integer. So we have to print the result is a plus, means we have to add this result to this text. That's why this we have used this concatenation symbol plus and a string for this result. So the first number, for example, 6, then second is a 5, the result will be 11. For example, 8, 9, the result is a 17. So we have to add these things when we are using the making the calculator. So make add the integer, that is show the status of number, that either it's a status of integer or float, or integer or float, and show the result with the string, because there is a string. That's why we, if we want to make the calculation proper, we have to write the proper query as well. So let's start coding and working on if statement. So for example, day is hot, and hot day is true. So if it is a hot day, then definitely you have to take care of you. So we have to take the data type hot day. You may give any name to this. For example, hot day is a true, means it's a really hot day. So if it's a hot day, then print it's a hot day, And there should be another message that should be the suggestion, take plenty of water. There should be a default message, enjoy the day at your home, don't go out. So this is the if condition, means we compare something. If we compare something, if it's a hot day, stay home. If it's a cold day, wear a hot clothes. So it depends on the condition. For example, this one, if you see, if it's a hot day, then it's a hot day, take plenty of water and enjoy the day at your home. Because I mentioned here true, but if I mentioned here false, then the result will be changed. So again, for example, this QB with the else, so for example, a hot day is a true, means it's a really hot day, and if it's a hot day, then message should be printed, it's a hot day and take plenty of water. If it's not a hot day, then else it's a cold day, then wear hot clothes, and there should be a default message on enjoy the day at your home. So now the true and false will change the result. For example, here it is a hot day. So I enter. So it will show it's a hot day. Take plenty of water and enjoy the day at home. And for example, I write here false. Means if it's a not hot day, then what should be here? Then it would be definitely cold day. So execute now. So it's a cold day because I make the hot day false. When hot day is a false, the contrast of this day hot is a cold. So the message again, block has been changed. Means this block is a printed that is associated with the else. Means it's a cold day. It's a cold day. And wear the hot clothes and enjoy the day at your home. So condition changes on the position that what are you showing there. Again, if you look here, if the hot day and cold day, I have taken two variables and I make the hot day false and the cold day true. So if hot day, definitely here the hot day is a false, then this action will be go to the cold day. Here another if block I have used, else if. And if both conditions definitely have not occurred, then this message is upper. However, here this message is by default. So look at this query. Because here the hot day is a false, means it's a cold day. So else if block is activated, that it's a cold day and wear hot clothes and enjoy the day at your home. That is a default. But if I make it true, means hot day is a true and false, cold day is a false, then the definitely here this message will not be appeared, but this message will be appeared. Let's see. So it's a hot day and to take plenty of water and enjoy the day at your home. That is a default message. So it depends. If block definitely, if conditions works on the conditions, that what are conditions here. So it, what are you going to show? You have to see the result. Now, for example, if I give you assignment, price of a building is a 2 million, and if buyer has a good credit, a good amount, so they need to put down 20%. Otherwise, they need to put down 20% and print the down payment. Would you? Would you print this result? It's a very easy. Let's see. So I have taken two data type. One is a price. Price is equal to 2 million. And good credit is a true because the buyer is in a good financial condition. So good credit is a true. So if good credit is a true, then down payment should be equal to the 2 million, means 0.2 into price. What is price? This one. So and else down payment, if the condition is not true and the condition is a false, then it should be 33 million. And make it the this statement formal. We learned already that we have used the if for formal position and payment and down payment. So let's result. You see, this is the result. So down payment is a 40 lakh. 4 lakh. The down payment is a 4 lakh. So it's easy. You may make it with a different amount and different conditions. You may make it. Another use of if and else, that is through the logical operators, means, for example, employee, so condition is a true and he's taking a good salary. So if employee and a good salary means then you may purchase a car on installment. Means, for example, you are going to bank, so bank will ask you either you are employee of a public or private organization and have you a good salary. If both conditions are true, then they will offer you car on the installment. So you may write program for different organizations. Let's see this program. So you may purchase a car on installments because employee's condition is good. But if the employee is not employee, but his income is good, then what will we do? No, because I didn't mention here the is, so result is nothing. And if you see, so again, and now we enhance this. For example, you don't have high income, and though you have a good credit at your level, so high income, or if you have good credit, you may purchase a car, means you are eligible for a loan. So look this. So this is a logical operator, or in the end, we are bound. Means both conditions should be true in the end, end operator. But in OR operator, one condition should be true. So there is no doubt his income is not high, but he is a good credit. So one condition is true and he is eligible for a loan. Another program, for example, if you have a high income, but you have and you don't have a criminal record, so you are also eligible for a loan. There are different and several conditions which you may be applied. For example, look here. So you are eligible for a loan. Another basic operation for any programmer is a loop. So loop in a Python works on two loops only, for loop and a while loop. So in the Python, while loop is used to execute a block of statements repeatedly until a given condition is satisfied. And when the condition becomes false, the line immediately after the loop in the program is executed. For example, the syntax of Python loop, if we look here, this is the syntax of the Python for the while, any expression you may give here, and then a statement, and then print this one. So this is the syntax of the for loop in the Python. For example, we are running this code. We have a data type count, and count is equal to 0. So while count is less than 5, then if the count is less than 5, then it print count, and count plus 1. So this is the same as count plus 1. You may write here the count plus 1 or here, count equal sign means add 1 to the count till it reach the destination. So there's no difference. You may even write the count plus 1. And if you write like this, so this will show that add 1 till reach this destination. So for example, we are executing it. So you see 0 because count is equal to 0. And when it reach the level of 5, then it end the loop. So here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when it reach the level of 5, then it is blocked. So this is the while loop. Means while loop start the condition, and when it reach the target, means it satisfied the block, and then it end it. Otherwise, it run till continue. So for example, another format of the while loop, I is equal to 1. In the first, the count was equal to 0. Here, I is equal to 1. And we run the while loop, and expression is I is less than equal to 5. And print I, and I is equal to I plus 1. Here, I use this method. while here I use this mirror. So it depends on you, what type of the method you are going to use. So when the process is computed, then it shows the message that it is done. So for example, we are executing it, and you see the value of variable was starting from 1. Since then, the first code, it was starting from the 0. But here, I make it I is equal to 1. So it has started 1. And here, the condition is changed. In the first format, there was the count less than to 5. But here, less than equal to 5. So when it reached the 5, then it finished the process. So it finished the process and show us the message that it is done. So it gradually added 1. It has added 1 to 1 and it is a 2. Then added 1 to 2, it is 3. Then added 1 to 3 and it is 4. And added finally it added 4 and it is 5. And when it goes to added 1 to 5, so it was going above the 5. Therefore, process is finished here. So while loop working like in this way in the Python or even other languages as well. So another example of while loop, for example, I is equal to 1 and while I is less than equal to 5, so print the asterisk. So here I give the asterisk into I means this is a multiplication symbol and this is a asterisk. What is different? Because this is a within the this is a string. Here, asterisk is a string. It is shown within the quotation number, single quotation quote. And here, the multiplication is shown directly. So it is multiplied by I. And 1 is added in each iteration. And when it is done, then it shows the message done. So let's see. So you see, this is the first. Because the value of I is a 1, then it is added multiplied by it is 1, then 1, and 4, 5, till 5. And when it is computed, when it is reached the destination, then it is finished. So, for example, we are going to start a game. So there is a secret number 9. There may be any secret number. And guess count that is equal to 0. And guess limit is a 3. So while guess count is less than or equal to guess limit, means iterate for 4 times. Since less than means it have to iterate for 4 times. And guess input guess. What will you guess? If you will not guess the 9, then it will run. Because the secret number is a 9. And it will ask for input. And then it will add 1 to each iteration. And if guess is equal to secret number, then it will show you message, you won the game. So you need to input even after getting true result, because while loop is executing. And to break this one, so let's solve this problem by breaking this. Otherwise, if I will not show here the break, then it will be continued. You will input, it will not end. So break, end it. And break the statement, this is a statement. This is a statement. So if you are not winning the game, then if condition means the condition is not met, then else statement will work. So it will show you message, sorry, try for again. So for example, we are running it. So for example, I am inputting here 7. And enter, and 8, and enter. Means it will run till I command 9. So you won the game. Means I have got the when I inputted the right number, I got the winning message. Because the secret number was 9. So here, even you may change, you may give what is the secret number given by the user. Even you may giving it by inputting the number. For example, secret number equal to input enter your secret number. And then this here, that number will be. So on this basis, we are developing a program for a car simulation. That, for example, we press the start. It show to start the start means to start the car, and stop means to stop the car, and quit means to exit the program. And here must be the help get you these all things. So for example, you write AST, so there should be a message, I don't understand, because here the word is a start, stop, and quit, and help. And if you are writing a start, then message will be shown to you, car is started, ready to go. And if you write a stop, then it will be shown to you, car is stopped. And definitely we will have to use the while condition, while we have to run while. So let's see the program. For example, command is equal to empty, and because of what we have to input, we'll see again. And while command dot lower, keep in mind the commands of what start, stop, quit should be in the lower case. So that's why if it should be in the lower case. So while command dot lower is equal to quit, and command input, that also should be in a lower condition, and command dot lower start is also in a lower. So the message will be shown to you, car is started. Else if you are writing the stop, the message will be shown to you, car is stopped. This is the automation system. Why automatic car are running on the road through the remote or any application. So this is a very little program. You may develop a huge program on basis of this concept. So else if, elif means else if, command is a help, so the menu will be shown to you. And so start, means car started, stop, car stop. This is a menu of help. And quit means to quit. So else if all no commands are used and you have pressed the quit, then the program will be quitted and message will be shown to you. Program is quit, established. Else, if you are not writing, sorry, I don't understand that if you are inputting the right wrong number. So let's execute this. So for example, I write here AS, only AS. So message come here, this message, because I have entered a wrong command. Sorry, I don't understand that. But if I write here help, because I don't know what commands are here to drive the car. So I need help, I write here help. So help is here, means start is a command that is used to car started, stop, you may stop the car, and quit, you may quit the program. So I write here start. So, okay, car is started. My car is started and it's ready to go. And it's some step, I want to stop the car and write here, stop. So car is stopped. Because I have stopped it. And now I want to quit the program. Or otherwise, if I want to start again car, then I will write here start. So again, car is started and ready to go. And now I want to quit because I want to stay. I reached the home and I want to stay at home. So I will quit the program and will quit. The program is quit. Now you may not input any command to the car. So this is the automation, how automatic cars are running on the road. So for example, I extend this. Same program, I make it more automatic. So it started means here, we don't know either car is already started or not started. So here I show that car is not started. It is just stay but not started. So if while if it is a true, means before quit was not equal to quit. Because it was started, and I don't know either car is started or not, because I'm at home and car is out of home, I don't know. So that's why I have programmed that the initial status of the car started is a false. This car is not started. So system will take input from you through this data type command. So you will enter the input, and that will be stored in the memory with this command. And if command is equal to start, then, and if it is started, means car is already started, but you are pressing button of start again and again, then this will show you message. The car is already started because you have pressed this button again. Else, started. If car is in a fast condition, means not started, then it will be started. Means started is a true. I make this started true. Here started is a false. So prevent car started ready to go. And else if command is a stop, you want to stop and car is already stopped, then it will, if not started, then it will show you message. But you mean even you may show message to driver, prevent car is already stopped. Else it is not, it is a running, not stopped, then again started false. Means we will go to this zero condition that you started, it is a false. And prevent car stopped. So else if command you need help, so this help menu will be shown to you. Else if you are pressing quit button, then program is a quit and a message will be shown to you. Program is a quit established. So let's run this program. Means I have modified some code to make it more automate. So for example, I write here start. The car is started. Now car is started. Again I write here start. Now look at the answer. Sorry, car is already started. This is automation. So because I have started the car and I have pressed again this button, so I got the message. Sorry, car is already started. So for example, I stop it. Stop. Car is stopped. I write again stop. So it will show me message that car is already stopped. Then again I write it start. So car is again, because car is started, start. And I say it start. So sorry, car is already started. So I say it stop. So car is stopped. Now I quit. Even you may get the help. Help is at this menu and I quit. I want to quit the program. So I will write here quit. So program is a quit stability. So this is the automation, that how we use the automation program using the loop. I told you, I teach you a little programs. You may write a more programs, not only for car, you may use this program for robot and other things as well. So now we will use the for loop. For loop is often we call the control loop that count the numbers. So far in for loops are used for definitely sequential traversal. And in Python there is a no C style for loop, that is for like this style. No, here the statement is a different. So if you look here, this is the for statement in Python, because for iterator variable any, because this is the iteration you may use in the for. For example, n is equal to 4 and for I in a range 0 and n and print I, you may use. So let's see the response. You see, I have n is equal to 4 and I run the loop for I is a data type and a range 0 to n, means it runs 0 to n. So here will the value of n is equal to 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So result is a right. Means you, and it is in a sequence. So for example, if I want to see how many characters are here in the Sinti, so I may see. So let's see. For example, see, S-I-N-D-H-I, and if I write here English, this is a E-N-G-L-I-H, complete. So you may use for loop for sequences, sequential purposes. Even for example, if you each word separate, you may see, for example, the sentence is Sindhi is a nation and word. So just press it. Now Sindhi is a nation. Means for using the for loop, it is separated. So for this expression is the same for word in. I use the in and this one. and you may write any sentence. And I have used just the in operator, that what is in this block, make it a separate. So in operator is a used. You may use in for different purpose. So I used in here, that what is there in this block, make it a separate. And print this. I printed this data with data type word. So even you may separate these numbers, like this message, these numbers may be separated. And even you may see the range, that what is the even the range of 10, you may see the even the range as well. So if I execute it, if you see, so first this result, this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is separated this. And the next command is show the range of 10. So the range of 10 is from 0 to 9. Even you may write it separate as well. And you may get the result separately. So you may get the range, that what is the range of 10 or 20 or so on. You may get it. Even you may use the data types or variables as well. For example, I'm running the loop for num as a data type in a range 5 to 10, that what is the range 5 and 10. So definitely range is a built-in function of the Python, and we use just we write here. So I execute it. So if you see, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 means what is the range of 10 starting from the 5. So it is started from 5 and to 9, because it shows the range of 10, which is started from 5. So even you may see the odd number as well. For example, I run the loop for having a data type num, and the range is, I told you, it is a built-in function of Python. So from 1 to 10 to 2 means this 2 will be added to 1, and then any number. So this will make it the odd, but if here it is a 1, then this will not be odd. So let's see. You see, this is a 1. Then these 2 are added to this 1, then it is a 3. Then 2 added to 3, then it is a 5. Then 2 added to 5, and result comes in 7. Then 2 added to 9, then result added to 9. So this is a odd numbers. If you want to see the odd number, you may run, you may see the run the range function of Python, that is a built-in for loop and data type, and you may get it. So now I run a program of the prices 10, 20, and 30. There are different prices of any product, and the total is a 0. So for price and the prices, now prices is a data type here. So how many prices? There are 3 prices, 10, 20, 30. You may change it as well. And the total, definitely what is total here, initial level, it is a 0, and what will be, it will be shown to you. So total is a basically total price plus price, that what is the price. So, or even you add augmenter as well. So here I add augmenter. You may get result from this QB as well as by adding the augmenter. So augmenter performs like this one. It depends on you, either you are using this QB or this QB, and then print the total. However, I have used the string format for the total to make it a good in good shape. So you see here 10, 20, 30 is a 60. So this is the total 60. So I have used augmenter here. If you want to use this command, you may use I close it with the hash and open this one, and you see. Same. The result is same. It depends on you that what type of the command are you using. Even you may use the without string as well, like this print as well. You may use it. If you are not writing the total with the
this one, only you need the number, you may use this command as well. Now we discuss the nested loop. Nested loops are very important in computing programming. So for example, this is the shape of a nested loop. These are the coordinates, x, y are the coordinates. So for example, 0 to 0, 0 to 1, 0 to 2, 1 to 0, 1 to 1, 1 to 2. So for example, if we want to see the range for x, x is a data type in a range 4. And print x means it shows the value of in a range. What is the value? Value is a 4. So it shows the value. And for x in a range 4, and I nested another loop with the y. This is a y, 0, and this is the x values, these are y values. So y in the range is a 3. And this y is a basically inner loop of the x loop. X loop is a outer loop, this is a inner loop. And print x and y. So the values will be printed from both sides. So you see, this is the value. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, the range of 4 here. And then again, when I run the nested loop, if you look here, if you don't want to run this, then this result will not come. But I just show you that the value of the range of x is a 0 to 4. So that's why, again, I run this loop for x in the range 4. And internal inner loop, that is the y loop for y in the range 3. So you see 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, and 1, and so on. So again, it repeats till it reach that destination. So you may run inner loop for any purpose. Again, this is a for loop. For example, we have a data and the number data type 52522. And means these are the data items in this data type. So for items in the numb, that is the data type, I'm going to print the x command and multiply that x with this is a asterisk as a multiplication sign with the items. So now, which are the items? These are the items. So then I add the inner loop. So number is equal to 12468. Number is equal to 12468. And for items in the number, result is equal to this blank. And for count in the range, that is the according to items. And then for result will be augmenter. It will be 8 asterisk. Means you may add even one number, any number, or any sign. I selected asterisk here and will get the result. So the result will be like this. If you see here, the x is a sign. I printed here the first it printed 5. If you look here, this is a 5. Then x, these items are 2. Then x is a 2. Then 5. Then 5. Then x 2. And then 2. So this loop is a completed. Then I added inner loop to this. So then I show the result in two asterisks. So if you see, first is a 1, then 2, then 4, then 6, then 8. So you may design anything I have given here. You may design with yourself, with your choice as well. So it depends on you that what is your choice and how you make making practice. Now we are finding the maximum large number from the list using the for loop. So we do have data elements of numbers 2, 6, 4, 10, 5. And these numbers are assigned to data type num. And maximum number, I don't know what is maximum number. For example, as a human, I know that 10 is a maximum. But a computer does not know that what is maximum number in this list. So this is the list. So for items, means items are these are the items of the list. This is a list, and these are the items of the list. So items in the num, if items greater than maximum or less than maximum, then maximum, if the item is less than maximum, then maximum is equal to items, so print max. So definitely it will print the max. For example, I run this. So here the maximum is the 10 number, definitely 10 number. And if I delete this one, then what will be the maximum? 6. And if you see, now it shows us the 6th number. So, for example, we are finding the minimum number from this. So, here the minimum number is a 2 as a human I know, but computer don't know. So, same command is run here. Here I use the last number and here the what is the less than, what is the minimum. So, I run it and you see here the 2. So, if you delete the 2, then what will be the minimum? What would you? 4. That's one. So it's a 4. So means you may run, find the minimum, maximum number from large numbers, huge numbers. It's easy to use. Even you may create the dimensional matrix as well. So for example, we are using the two-dimensional data in a list. This is a list and solving two-dimensional matrix. For example, we do have a data as below. This is the data of the matrix. So what we will do, we define the matrix data type and input the data. This is the matrix data and print this matrix starting from 0 and 1 is we have two attributes. So we just print it. So here it's a 2 definitely. And if I print the matrix, now you see these are the matrix, first matrix, second and third. This is the first, 1, 2, 3, second, and this is the third. So you may print it. So we have done the strings, numbers, and different operations of strings and numbers, and if else functions, and loops as well. So now you have to do the practice of this. This is the first part. So if you will not make practice, then definitely you will not understand the Python. So hope you like it. You got it. I tried to take you a little time. That's why I did not go into detail, because you know what is the detail of this. I focus the first initial commands. You learn the print, that what is the functional print and how to print the message in Python. Then I show you how to print the numbers, how to calculate the numbers. I focus these things. Definitely I don't want it to repeat again their definition and functionality, and I go fastly. Because I don't want to take you more time, then we discussed, I come to the conditions, and I told you how to use the conditions in the Python, if condition, if else condition, if else if, and else condition, and we did some examples, and given you assignment as well, and then we worked on the loops. As I told you, Python is using while loop and for loop. So we did work on those, and we used the nested loop as well. So hope you like it and you got some information. My purpose is to change you and nothing else. So subscribe this channel to get more notifications. We will come very soon with the second part, and that will be some more professional. This was initial and for the beginner, so it was not the of complex, but second part may be a little bit complex, because that will be for the professionals, and then we will go to the learn the machine learning and deep learning. Till that, take care, stay blessed.